If you depend on any software for your daily workflow, then it's important to have your software working correctly with your current operating system, and both of these working correctly with any external devices that you want to output to. Before you purchase any software, you should always check out the minimum system requirements. That way, you'll save yourself a lot of frustration down the line. CorelDRAW editions are no exception. Each version was and is written with specific system architectures in mind. Here, for example, I have an overview of which CorelDRAW versions will run on which Windows or Mac operating systems. Why is it important that you run the correct version of CorelDRAW for your operating system? Software, as opposed to, say, audio or video files, isn't something standard that all operating systems will know how to interpret. Software is code that runs on your computer and, as I mentioned before, is written to be compatible with specific operating systems. So if you try to install a program that was written for Windows 98 or 2000, it is highly likely to malfunction if it finds itself running on Windows 8, 10, or 11, if you can get it installed at all, that is. The software will try to look for files and drivers that no longer exist, and it might even be unable to run at all in an unfamiliar environment. You can try to run older software in Windows Compatibility Mode, but even that might not work. Also, modern Windows security features mean that limited user accounts and UAC, user account control, can affect how and if a program will run correctly. You could try to trick an older CorelDRAW Graphics Suite into running under a limited user account, but this doesn't guarantee that it will fix every problem. If you're running an older CorelDRAW Graphics Suite on a system that it wasn't written for, trying to run CorelDRAW X6 on Windows 10 or 11, for example, a couple of things could occur. You might encounter installation errors and might not be able to successfully install updates. If you do manage to get it installed, the software itself might show instability. After saving a file and trying to reopen it, you might encounter a file corrupted or unreadable error message. Finally, even if the program runs okay initially, following operating system updates, it could become buggy. These issues affect not only CorelDRAW. Design work needs to be output to a printer, plotter, or maybe an engraving machine. Some manufacturers supply proprietary software with their machines. This could take the form of software, such as Roland's VersaWorks RIP, for example, that works as a standalone application and accepts raster and vector files in the following formats: JPEG, EPS, PDF, PostScript, and TIFF, all export formats that are supported by CorelDRAW. In addition, the legacy file format PLT, or HPGL plotter file, is still supported in the graphics suite. RIPs from other manufacturers, such as Mimaki's FineCut or Euro Systems CoCut, on the other hand, build themselves into CorelDRAW as additional toolbars. Here it's important to check on the relevant websites which versions of the RIP will work with your particular CorelDRAW version. On Mimaki's product pages, for example, we can see which versions of CorelDRAW FineCut 9 will support and, more importantly, which ones it won't work with. The same applies for CoCut. Again, these software RIPs will also have minimum system requirements which should be adhered to. So just to summarize what we've covered so far, running old CorelDRAW versions on incompatible operating systems can result in program instability and possible data loss when saving new or opening legacy files. Required software RIPs needed for output must also be supported by the correct CorelDRAW version and current operating system.